Hey you all, welcome to this wonderful month, beautiful month, marching to victory. Day 1 of March. I'm so glad to meet you all in this day. This is very special month. This is the 12th month of that Hebrew calendar. Every time when the leap year comes, they add second Adar. If not only one Adar. This month is called Adar. In Hebrews, every month is attached to a letter, to a color, to a constellation, to a tribe. This month tribe is Naphtali. Naphtali is the sixth son of Jacob. He was born for the maid of Rachel. Naphtali means sweetness unto me. When Jacob blessed, the fullness of God's blessing will be for Naphtali. Also, he will be like a deer. He will be like a deer and his communication will be so sweet. Moses blessed in Deuteronomy 33, the fullness of God's blessing will be, the fullness of God's favor will be upon Naphtali. He is one of the tribes placed in the northern side of tabernacle. He was in fact rear guard of other two tribes. Beautiful Barak, the one who stood with Deborah, is from the Naphtali tribe. What is the significant in this month? Every time I pray for our nation, what God showed, how he is establishing our President Trump back very majestically in the throne, I always get this vision, a beautiful marching. The lions are marching. Lion of tribe of Judah is marching, holding, leading Trump at the with the right hand. And also you and me as the lions, marching, following. So I was really waiting to step into this month. This month, especially the month of faith, prophetically, so this is one of the way we can be aligned and manifested in God's blessing. Understanding time and season, understanding what God is doing. In God's calendar, everything is a circle. On the exact Passover day, Jesus Christ was crucified. On the festival of first fruit, Jesus was raised from the dead. On the day of Pentecost, when the Israelites received the law in Mount Sinai, here in Acts 2, the church of God received the Holy Spirit, the promise of the Father. On the day of tabernacle, we believe that Jesus Christ, the Word became flesh and tabernacled among us, in us. He came to this earth. The day of the Feast of Trumpet, Jesus is going to come. So even though those things are shadow, when we observe, when we believe, when we release our faith, we receive the blessings, what God has done. So in this month, in the second Adar, as I mentioned before, in the leap year, the Purim was celebrated. 13th day was Esther's festival. 14th was Purim. In this month, this is so amazing. This month is month of God is breaking all the depression and despair and turning them into the blessing, breakthrough. You can clearly see how God is translating you from depression to the gladness. This is the mission of our Lord Jesus Christ. He said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He sent me to set the captives free, to preach this good news to the poor, to open the prison doors, to free them who are imprisoned, to give them the gladness the praises, garment of praises for those who are in the heaviness, to turn their ashes into beauty. This is what exactly God is changing our despair and depression into dancing and gladness. Especially, this is the month your Haman is going to be hung. The one who plot you, the one who chase you, stole your promotion, stole your elevation, stole your blessing, stole your blessing. They are going to be identified. They are going to be eradicated. Beautiful. Sweetness unto me. God is going to, you know, you are going to, the rootness of the gladness. You are going to see how God is translating you. Especially in the time of our national crisis. What God is going to do. And also this is a month of effective, eloquent communication. You can ask God. Isaiah 50 says, God wakes me up every morning. He give me a tongue of educated one. He opens my ears. I can listen to him. I am anointed to speak the right seasoned words to the people. He gives the educated ears. Psalm 45 says, my tongue is the pen of the ready writer. God gives, improves, gives the gift of communication. Vocal kingdom. Verbiage potent. Effective speech. I was praying for that. It is so beautiful. This month is the month of communication. God will give the gift of tongues, interpretation. You can speak the right time, right word. And also the faith. Without knowing what is the exact, the observing the month, the tribe and all this, early in the morning, I was singing a song. Spontaneously, the Spirit of God was anointing me and then I was receiving a song. Lord, fill me with the gift of Spirit. The gift of the faith, fruit of faith. God gives the faith without measure. And then I was just going over the month, the Hebrew, the month calendar, my Google Doc. I realized, wow, this month is the month of faith. Without faith, no one can please God. Sometimes even we take this, you know, as familiar. Paul said, I live by the faith of the Son of God. What an amazing grace revelation upon Paul. He says that the faith that I believe, the use, is not even my faith. I exactly believe like the Son of God believed, because I believe by the faith of the Son of God. I live by the faith of Son of God. Habakkuk, it says, righteous shall live by the faith. Hebrews, it says, righteous shall live by faith. Galatians, it says, the righteous shall live by faith. What does that mean? It's the breath. It is the basic need. When the Son of Man returning, he is not looking who interceded vibrantly, who prophesied sharply, who stood in the blameless holiness. Don't criticize using this part. He is going to see whether there is faith or not. Do you have faith? We serve the God of Bible. When Elisha prayed, Lord, open my servant's eyes, he will see the chariots and how many angels are surrounding, the more with us than with the Syrian army. God opened the eyes of the servant to see the mighty angelic army around the prophet. The same prophet in 1 Kings 6, 2 Kings 6, he prays that, Lord, just command the blindness on the enemy. God immediately granted that. The enemy couldn't figure out where Elisha was. They're blinded just right away. Where is our faith? When Joshua prayed, God made sun to stop in the valley of Ayalon. And he stopped the moon. It is even recorded around 3000 plus years. Scientists are proving God stopped the sun. Why? Why Joshua? Why? It pleased God. Joshua is asking, until I eradicate your enemy, stop the moon, stop the sun, stop the clock. God loves this spirit. God needs the Joshua and Caleb in this year, in this season. It's not like talk about second coming of Jesus. We all believe second coming of Jesus Christ. In which spirit? You know, the people are preaching. I'm so happy. Yes, we always 24/7 preach the fullness of the gospel. This earth is not our permanent place. We know that. But in which area, in which sense, in which circumstances you are preaching, the spirit matters. Few years ago, I went to visit my mother. Just I took 10 days vacation as I was in a contract job. I had limitation, only 2 weeks I can take off. I never expected. After third day, I reached to my mother's home. She was diagnosed with a cancer, which was very shocking. At the time, God was using me very mightily. Whatever the prayer request, many people given up by doctor. Miracles left and right. I never know this attack will come for my mom. And then I was approaching many people, many servants. I'm giving. They're asking, what is the age? Oh, what doctors are telling? Okay, let us pray. Anyway, she is saved. She will be rejoicing in the heaven. There is no point. Everybody, at least 100 people, it broke my heart. No one, not one single servant said, no, your mom will live. The cancer will be cursed. The cancer will be gone. But one precious sister from very poor family, she comes in a bus, 1.5 hours traveling. She always comes, you know. No, mom will not die. This cancer will go away. I still couldn't forget her prayer. My mom is gone. My mom was gone. It doesn't matter. But that prayer stayed in my heart forever. In our global mission, people come, doctors giving up. We pray till the end. No, don't pray. Just to let them depart peacefully. No, we pray. And then doctors said, yeah, they're gone. Then immediately 3 days, 4 days, we gather and pray, raise the dead. But the people who gave the request, are they gone from us? No. They saw the true love. We stood for them. The inauguration, fake puppet, whatever the Biden, they came and immediately, what you are doing? Where is your faith? Where is your faith? Abraham believed in God. In which age? He did not consider his body. When God said he will perform, he will perform. God is looking for the faithful generation, faith-filled generation. We are not just the sending apostles, and we are the ascending people. God understands only the language of faith. Heaven's currency is faith. Every so-called ministers are telling the prophets, wrong prophets, they are telling. Why? Why? It did not happen. Why? Oral Roberts, the great, beautiful, amazing healing evangelist. There was a question once asked to him. If you prayed for 99 people, they all died, what will you do? You know what he said? I will pray with the same faith for the 100th person. Praying with the faith is my part. Result is God's part. Don't even hurt prophetic people, prophets saying that it is just sticking with your own man-made dates and timing. It quenches their anointing. When God said they are releasing, is it awesome before God's eyes? Is it very amazing, beautiful, obedient? I'm telling, even the day before yesterday, God was telling, date 28. What is that, Lord? Every time I'm getting date, I'm communicating, I'm not sure. No, Lord. I was first time, I was telling, hesitating. And then God said, it's Wednesday. Okay, Lord. Then, add that together, it will be one. I don't want to argue with my Lord. I took the calendar. What 28 is there? April 28th, It is on Wednesday, and then it came as one. Something will happen on that day, but I'm not sure what is that. I'm not sure what is that. It might be for my personal, but 24/7, I am praying. I am standing in faith for our President Donald John Trump will take the seat back. He is the president. He is our president. Not anyone else. This is the month that I wanted to give the verse. This, even the title, it says a hymn of faith. Hymn of faith in Habakkuk chapter 3. Though the fig tree may not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, though the labor of the olive may fail, and the fields yield no food, though the flock may be cut off from the fold, and there be no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the Lord, God of my salvation. The Lord is my strength. He will make my feet like deer's feet, and He will make me walk on the high places. This is the month. God will give you the feet like a hind's feet. God will translate every depression into breakthrough. Psalmist says, don't gloat over me, enemy. If I fall down, the Lord will raise me up. If I walk in the darkness, my Lord will be the light. Psalms in 18, he says, even my Lord will change my darkness into the light. Psalms 139 says, even I am in the midst of the darkness, your light, O Lord, will be round about me even in the night. This is the hour we are believing, we are standing. God is going to establish our nation. The wicked shall flee when no man pursue. When the storm passes by, the wicked is no more. God will drive out all the wild beasts, and God will establish our President Donald Trump. Let us keep marching. Let us keep believing. Let us just stand firm, steadfast, and keep praying. God will honor our faith. He is the rewarder of our diligent faith. Amen. Thank you all. God bless you all. Wish you all have an amazing, beautiful, marching, victorious, successful, amazing month. You will accomplish more than any other season in this season. Amen. Thank you. God bless you all. Amen.